My ignition switch started to give me trouble, so we replaced it. There's a lot of videos on the internet showing how to do it, but a lot of them make it more difficult than it needs to be. So I'm going to show you the easy way to do it. First thing is to turn the battery off, which I forgot. Okay, now that I have the battery disconnected, first thing to do is to raise the steering wheel up all the way up. Then pull the lever out. You may have to pull kind of hard, but just give it a good pull and it'll come right straight out. And you can see a little lip. Basically what it looks like here when it's pulled out. Good picture of that. It'll focus. But anyway, just a little piece. Got little things on the end there, catches into the rubber. The next thing to do is just to grab on the key side to get the camera a little better on that. What you want to do is pull down right here. And that just pulls down. And pull down also on the other side. Okay, once you got it pulled down, loose, there's some tab, a little rubber piece back here that the tab fits in. You just kind of push down, push back on it a little bit. Like so. Kind of pull this down and push back on the little rubber tab. Do the same thing on the other side. And just bring it down. Most of these do not have screws, but you do want to double check and make sure there's screws. Two screw holes and one just empty hole there. Empty hole there. You want to make sure there aren't any screws there, which I've already done. Okay. I pulled this off earlier and you gotta push this back a little bit. Push it down. Push it towards the engine and it'll come down. You've got this lip right here that wants to stick. And then you can just pull it right out. And you can see the two screw holes here. We got that in there. Got the one right there, and the other one over here. And then right here, you got the little empty hole there. And when you're looking at the underneath the bottom, it might fool you as being a screw hole, but there you go. So anyway, okay, you can see in my hand that way. All right, you can see the ignition switch. This right here is the ignition switch. It'll pull down. There's two little tabs you got to push in right there and right back here. You got to push in with a screwdriver. And then that'll allow this to come straight down. Now before you can pull it down, there's a little clip that holds this wire. That needs to be, see a little clip right in there. That wire just needs to be brought around that little clip. If I can get a better picture there. A little clip right there. Gotta get that wire out. Like so. Alright, now we can bring the piece down. There it goes. The easiest way to get this thing off is don't stick the screwdriver right here. Instead, get a small screwdriver, stick it up in here, and just bring it this way. Pop that right out, and it pops out. And that will come right out. But it's hard to do with the phone. Trying to hold on to the camera at the same time, but there you go. You can see it's loose. Pull it down, and then after you got that connection loose, just pull it down, and that connection will come right off. And you want to do this with the key out, not with the key in. That way you don't accidentally turn the key and reposition in another position. tell the new ones from the old ones, because the new ones are light gray. A light gray paddle. But these are black. Now you want to line up your new one so it looks the same. So you can see they're not lined the same, so you just gotta turn the new one. Just make sure you don't turn the old one. Turn that around. I'm gonna work on the gray one. So we'll just turn that down so it lines up same position as the other. You can see that opening that I just turned out. You can barely see the opening. I don't know if you can see it in the camera, but yeah, you can quite see it there. You can see the one on the right is the new one, and you can turn that down just a little bit more to be the same. That looks pretty good. Now I'll just stick it in the new one in. Stick it in place. Like it's gonna make the connection, but don't actually tighten it in. Just so it's just barely in there, and then hold it in place while you slide the piece back in. That seems like the easy way. Thing is, you got over here, you got a wire tie that's holding this wire together, making it stiff. You could cut the wire tie off and then have to put a new wire tie in. Then you'd have a lot easier time doing this, but I'm gonna leave the wire tie there. And now that I got it most of the way, I'm going to go ahead and slip the electrical connection in. And it should pop, so you hear it snap in. There's the next snap sound. Make sure you got it in all the way. And then snap the switch in. Push that in. And that snaps in. Now before we put the cover on, hook up the battery, and we'll give it a test to make sure it works. So if you take the key out, you think it's turned off, and it's still draining your battery. It's not turned off all the way. So everything looks good, so now all we got to do is put that piece back on, and we'll be finished. These little parts here are a little tricky getting them in. They want to get in the way, especially that one right there. Sometimes you'll try to get it in and you'll notice this thing's a little bit bent. Put the back end up first, put it in up first. And then there's a little rubber thing, you just push it into that. The one in the back that we had to push on with a finger. And you might not even have to, like this other one, I didn't have to put my finger back there to hold it. I just push the thing back in. You may not even have to put your finger on it. Get that line back into that rubber thing. And the other thing is, when you're putting it in, if you have trouble getting it up, make sure this lip right here is up into the steering. Now we've lined up right. It's real easy to try to push it in like it is now. And it's not far enough this way. there it is. When you have it right, it snaps in easy. But again, you just gotta, it's real easy to be trying to push it in, trying to fight it. Don't fight it, because you'll bend those little plastic things I was talking about. But just make sure you got up. And pop it right in. Then last, we got the little lever switch. That just snaps in. You got the long side and short side. You see, you got long side there on top, short side there. So the long side actually goes on the bottom when you put it in. Short side goes on top. It snaps in. And we are done. One of the things, the ignition switch, it can cause going bad, can cause a variety of things to happen. Your instrument panel, certain parts may not work. You can even have transmission problems that you think is expensive transmission problem and ends up just really being an ignition switch problem. Because what happens with the transmission is the computer's communicating with the transmission and to tell it the engine speed. If the transmission's not getting that communication, so for example, the wire going back is disconnected or not getting good connection, or if the ignition switch is not making that connection right, then the transmission does not know how fast your engine is going, and so it just has to guess as to when. And you'll find that when that's happening, your transmission will change gears at a lower RPM than normal, and it'll hit pretty hard, so you want to be careful when it starts doing that, because you could end up with turning an inexpensive transmission problem into a very expensive transmission problem. Replace the switch and you're all good to go. Some of the other videos were saying you have to take this stuff off and all the instrument panels. As you can see, this one panel underneath the steering wheel is all you got to take off. And of course, the little things are adjust, tilt. And there you have it.